Avengers.
What was that?
Me down before anything else shows up. Yes, the claw. I know how it works. The claw, the markings, the door in the hall of stories. I know how they all fit together. Help me down and I'll show you. You won't believe the power the Nords have hidden there. Does it look like I can move? You have to cut me down first. I can feel it. You fool. Why should I share the treasure with anyone? Why should I share the treasure with anyone?
Anybody there?
Yeah.
Oh, pardon me. Is that in your way? My pa used to say, there ain't no use worrying about the things you can't change. If it's my fate to be ended by a dragon, so be it. Meantime, I'll live my life the way I want to. Sometimes the difference between life and death is a swift and steep.
Assist,
May your road lead you to warm sands.
Welcome. Take a look.
I hope that you will come.
We are creatures. Take a look. Take a look.
May the sun keep you warm, even in this land of bitter cold. Until our next meeting, in if such is fate.
The wind blows bitter cold in
the Gazit must stay on the lookout for thieves.
Between the war,
always cut off the heads. Then the lips. Garzam,
lie our day.
I admit that I and are concerned. We can avoid
I used to hate it here, but it's not so bad anymore. Constance is real good to us. Why someone like you want to hang around a place like this? Constance Michel says we have to be careful of people we don't know.
When I grow up, I'm going to be an assassin. That way I can help lots of children, just like you!
I was named after the
This war has created so many orphans.
You know,
and so few are willing to open their hearts to them. I can't believe Grelod is dead. I had no love for the woman, but to be murdered in cold blood. Why, yes. Yes, of course. What a wonderful surprise. First, I'll need to ask you a few questions. Your name? What do you do for a living? Mm-hmm. Where will your child be living? Look. Let's be realistic. You're an adventurer. It's not exactly a safe or reliable profession. I need to be sure your child will have a safe, stable home to grow up in. Show me that you can support a child, buy a house, furnish it, then come back and we'll talk.
Hollyfrost farm outside the city. It's honest work, if a bit dull.
You must be one of those wizards from the college in Winterhold.
Come on in. Let me know if you need anything. Take a seat by the fire and I'll send someone over.
Just glad all that business with Malin is over with. What did you need? All right, then.
Just say the word if you need a drink or something to eat.
Hey. Okay. I didn't miss out on anything, did I?
Ready to get moving? I'm right behind you.
Close enough. Who are you? Oh, it's you. I'm so glad you're here. Look, I don't know how much time we have left. My brother went down this shaft a few days ago, and I'm worried. I need you to go in after him and bring him back to me alive. It could be dangerous, but if anyone can do it, it's you. Now, are you ready? I knew I could count on you. Now quickly, go! Look, are you ready to go or not? All right, but please hurry. My name's Cassia. My brother and I came to Skyrim from Cyrodiil with the Imperial Legion. But we took a break to explore these ruins. We didn't want to get involved in this stupid war in the first place. We only came here because we were conscripted. But our unit was wiped out by Nords and those forsworn savages, and we saw a chance to get away from the fighting altogether. So we took it. Well, we came here hoping to find something valuable to pay for carriage back to Cyrodiil. Altrius went down the shaft, but he asked me to stay here. Because he made me promise I'd stay here and wait for him, no matter what. And I keep my promises. Well, except as far as the Legion is concerned. I was in Markarth looking for help, when I heard people talking about you and all the loot you've been trading with merchants all over Skyrim. I figured you'd be interested in exploring these ruins, so I asked a courier to track you down. And here you are. So you're ready to go now? I knew I could count on you. Now quickly, go!
Should we get moving? Thank you.
We heading out? Let me just conjure up the energy.
I was in your shoes once, a lifetime ago. I remember the way the lake house calls to you. stop you from making the same mistake I made. You ignore my words and come searching for the key.
Don't worry about me. I'm in the best shape of the slow tour. Did I ever tell you what my name means? Old old Mary. That's no idea. Some say Rumarin is a feminine name, but I'm not a girl, I just fight like one. Already? We haven't even told each other our deepest, darkest fears yet. Mine's centaurs. There. Now we can go our separate ways. Yes?
Private lake house. Yeah, well, just make sure you don't get lost in anyone else's home. Live by our laws here, and we'll all get along just fine. Don't hurt anyone, don't steal anything. Same as anywhere else. Only the punishment here is much. Much worse. The Jarl can tell you more, and help you get settled in. Might even have some quarters for you. I can take you to him if you like. Follow me. So, this is our farmland where we grow all the food you'll ever want. As long as all you ever want is leek, cabbage, and potato. If you have goods, the merchants at the market up ahead will be happy to see you. Most of us have few belongings. Just what we brought in with us.
Morning, Gulvar.
Morning, Nismar. Above us is the sun under the ground. It's strange and no substitute for the real sun, of course, but these days it doesn't bother me. What bothers me is the Citadel folk. Take Jormat, for example, standing up there on his balcony looking down on us. Just look at him.
Yeah, you're a really big man, aren't you?
Milk drinker.
Aren't you going to introduce me to your strapping new friend, Gulvar?
We're on our way to see the Jarl. There'll be time for you to get your claws into our friend here later.
I look forward to it. You should come for a drink at my tavern, the Gold Sentinel, tonight. Just about everyone's there after dark.
Be careful with Rastasia. She... Well... It's not my place to say. There's enough gossip in this place as it is. It's a small city, after all.
Only 24 of us at the moment. 23 if you don't count Brandus, who's halfway to the next life. Luke is barely managing to keep him alive. This is the Citadel, where the Jarl and his guests live.
If you manage to worm your way in with them, you might get to live here too.
Gulver, what do you think you're doing? You're meant to be working the Owl's farm, not trudging dirt into his citadel.
Yeoman, take it easy, would you? I was just showing our new friend here to the Jarl.
Well, how about you get back to work, and I take our new friend the rest of the way? If you don't work, none of us eat, Gulver. Remember that.
How could I forget?
Fine, I'll get back to work. It was nice meeting you, my friend. Stop by for a chat anytime you like.
I'm sorry about that. That probably sounded a bit harsh, but it's my job to make sure we all have enough to eat. I'm Yeomond. Let's head up to the next floor then, shall we? Stay close behind me. Wouldn't want you getting lost now, would we? It's good to see a new face here. Haven't had any new arrivals in a while. Except for Marius. But he mostly keeps to himself. Bit secretive, actually. Most people are pretty friendly though. And so they should be. This is the closest you'll get to Sovereign Guard in all of Tamriel. No crime, no conflict. Most of them don't even bother locking the doors. Even if you could steal something without breaking the dwarves' law, it's not as if you could sell it to anyone here. Out Brawl down in the city, our resident expert about the history and laws of the Dwemer. Last I heard, they were trying to track down some dwarven artifacts. Should ask Brawl about it, if you're into that sort of thing. This is the Citadel kitchen. Remember to be polite to our cook Asanchi. She does the best with what she has, which isn't much. Now let's head up to the Yarl's floor. Alright, so we're about to meet Jarl Metellus. There's a couple of things you should know about him, if you want to make a good impression. First, he was the first one here. Well, he was here before the rest of us anyway. So the Citadel is his, and we're all his guests. Second, he's very protective of this place, and won't tolerate anyone disturbing the peace. So be on your best behaviour, and you should be fine. This is the top of the Citadel. The bathhouse is off limits, and I'm not even sure what's behind the gold door. Oh, the Jarl has ever got in there. Alright, you're on your own from here. I've got lazy farmers to supervise. Good luck with the Jarl, and I'll see you around.
The Jarl is waiting for you on his balcony, on your left.
There's a face I don't recognize. Welcome to my city. I'm Jarl Metellus. Tell me, what is your name? It's always exciting to meet a new member of our small community. Now, before I forget, since you're here for good, you'll need some quarters. Here's a key to the last vacant chambers down in the city, between Brawl and Luki. It's all yours. Now tell me, what brings you to my city? I sent you here. I'm not sure what you mean. Well, let's see. This is my handwriting. The victims of an unspeakable atrocity. I will open a portal that will take you into the past. You must go back. This is real, isn't it? I've even toyed with the idea of creating a portal between two points in time, with Brawl's help. But that's odd. My letter makes no mention of what caused the disaster. I suppose I was in a hurry. So tell me, what's going to happen to us? That's exactly what I saw when I first discovered this place, several years ago. It seems whatever happened then is going to happen again. I think it has something to do with the dwarves' lore. This is bad. This is very, very bad. Yes, you see, the dwarves who built this place left inscriptions. Brawl hasn't been able to fully translate them, but we understand some parts. This warning keeps coming up. The many shall suffer for the sins of the one. We think that breaking the law here will cause some kind of event. The truth is, I've used the dwarves' lore to frighten my people into obedience, and it's worked so far. But someone's about to break that law. Let me think. Your arrival here is exactly what I need. You've helped me a great deal by bringing this note to my attention. I wonder if you could do me another favor. I need you to investigate the city, talk to my people, help them, if it'll win their trust. You can even go through their possessions, if you have to. You must work out who is going to break the dwarves' law. Once you have a name, come back and tell me immediately. As Jarl, I authorize you to go anywhere you need to go, including private homes. But if someone asks you to leave, you should do so immediately. I can't promise either of those things, but I will certainly do everything within my power to help you, once you've helped my people. And of course, if you decide to stay, I would make sure you enjoy a comfortable life here. Now what do you say? Will you help me? Thank you. Now, you mustn't tell anybody where you're from or what may be about to happen here. If it helps you, you're welcome to borrow the book on my desk. It contains the names and addresses of my subjects. Just don't show it to anyone. Goodbye for now, and good luck. I don't need to tell you what will happen if you fail.
Nice to see someone in the Citadel who isn't an Imperial for a change. Hey there. Well, as you know, the Jarl is my father. Or, at least, that's what he tells people. What he doesn't tell anyone is that I'm adopted. And the worst part is, I don't even know why he adopted me in the first place. Sometimes I feel more like his prisoner than his daughter. If we weren't trapped in here, I'd run away in a heartbeat. Oh, he really is. He's always telling everyone what to do. I don't know how everyone puts up with him. And he and his friends don't do any work. Everything gets done by the people down in the city. But don't just do whatever he says. People around here should really learn to stand up to him. You know my father would be upset to hear you ask that. I love it. Me, not even allowed out of the Citadel. Father doesn't want me mixing with the common folk. He's all, why don't you read one of the books Gaia brought you? Books? I'm almost 18. I want to have fun, like... I thought about getting one of those awful Nord tattoos. Father would hate that. I don't want to drink it. Oh, but if I get some, I just know I could get that junkie to spill her guts about everyone in this place. You got some? Well done. Now, take it down to Asanshi in the kitchen and see if you can squeeze her for information. It'll be hilarious.